Discovery of Temporal Universe. My name is Lucy Yu. I'm the narrator of this video presentation by Professor Francis T. S. Yu on an article which was published in the Asian Journal of Physics and in a chapter in his recent book titled Entropy and Information Optics, Connecting Information and Time. In writing this article, I have mostly based on the constraints of the law of physics to illustrate time as the origin of creating our physical space, that is our universe. Physical reality exists with the passing of time, and it is supported by the laws of science, while virtual reality is created without the constraints of time, and it is not supported by the law of physics. One of the enigmatic variables in the rules of science is time. So, what is time? Time is a variable and has no substance, no mass, no weight, no coordinate, no origin, and it cannot be detected or even be seen. It can only move forward and it cannot move backward. Yet, time is everlasting. Everything is associated with time. This includes our universe. When dealing with science, time is one of the most intriguing variables that we cannot ignore. Strictly speaking, all the laws of physics, as well as all the physical substances, could not exist without the existence of time. Now, let's look at energy and energy reservoir. Energy is the physical quantity that governs the existence of substances. Every substance is created by energy, and every substance is capable of converting back to energy. Energy and substance are exchangeable. Mass can be treated as an energy reservoir. Our universe is compactly filled with mass and energy. Nevertheless, without the existence of time, the trading between mass and energy cannot happen. Einstein's energy equation, E approximately equals to mc squared, where energy is approximately equal to mass times the velocity of light squared. Since all the laws in science are approximations, I intentionally use the approximation sign. However, in practice, the amount of energy produced should be smaller than the equivalent amount of mass as shown below. E is less than mc squared. Energy conversion. In view of Einstein's equation, it takes time to convert mass into energy. Thus, without the inclusion of time variable, the conversion would not get started. In fact, Einstein's equation is a representation of total amount of energy to be converted from a rest mass. In other words, every mass has an energy storage capacity, as given by Einstein's equation. By incorporating the time variable, the equation can be represented by a partial differential form, as given by the equation below, where the partial derivative of energy with respect to time is the rate of energy conversion. C is the speed of light, and the partial derivative of mass with respect to time is the corresponding rate of mass reduction. trading mass and energy. One of the important aspects of Einstein's energy equation is that energy and mass can be traded, so that the rate of energy creation from mass can be written in terms of radiant energy as given by equation below, in which we see that exploded energy diverges from mass, that is del dot S, where S is the divergence of energy vector, and the last term represents the diverge of radiation density. Similarly, the creation of mass from energy can also be shown by the following equation. The major differences of this equation as compared with the former one is the energy convergent operator minus del dot S, in which we see that energy converges into a small volume to create the mass. Since mass creation is inversely proportional to the speed of light squared, it would take a lot of energy to produce a small quantity of mass. Nevertheless, in the cosmological environment, availability of huge amount of energy has never been a problem. In our physical world, every matter is a substance. The reason is that they were all created by means of energy or mass. As we mentioned before, our physical space, that is our universe, is fully packed with substances. There is no absolute empty space in it. Nonetheless, all physical substances have to exist with time. In our universe, no physical substance can exist forever. Neither can they exist without time. Thus, every physical substance is involved with time and space, which I call temporal space. Therefore, we see that without time, and there will be no substance and no universe. Physical substance and time. On the other hand, time cannot exist without existence of substance. That is, time and substance have to simultaneously exist. One cannot exist without the other. Therefore, if our universe has to exist with time, then our universe will eventually get old and die. So the essence of time may not be as simple as we think. For example, a species live in a far distant galaxy move closer to the speed of light. Their time goes somewhat slower relative to ours. We can see that time may not be the same at different subspaces. For example, at the age of our universe. As we know, every conversion, either from mass to energy or from energy to mass, cannot start without the ignition of time. Then time and substance have to simultaneously coexist. So every physical substance, including our universe, coexists with time. We can describe this relationship by a time-space dimension representation as given by the following equation. This equation is a function of space and time, where time is a forward variable. Let's move on to substance and physical space. Absolute empty space cannot exist in physical reality. Every physical space needs to be completely filled with substance, including our universe. It is not possible that there is empty space in it. Let me repeat again. Mass and energy coexist with time. Without the existence of time, there will be no mass, no energy, no universe. We see once again that every physical substance coexists with time. Furthermore, our universe is a bounded subspace. Since a physical space cannot be embedded within an absolute empty space, then our universe has to be embedded in a more complex physical space. This, of course, remains to be found. If we accept our universe is embedded in a more complex space, then our space has to be a bounded subspace. It is our aim, within the laws of science, to investigate the enigmatic time as it exists within our universe. Let's get back to Einstein's energy equation as given in differential form, where positive and negative del dot S represents the divergent and convergent energy operations respectively. For example, black holes are known celestial energy converging operators, while stars, that's our sun, are the known diverging energy sources. Moreover, the essence of the above equation shows the transformation from dimensionless, that is, singularity, quantity, to dimensional space-time representation. From this equation, we see that all the physical substances were created by energy and time, that is, every physical subspace is created by substances. In short, we see that del dot S is a function of space and time. T is time variable. This is a time space or a temporal space representation. Let's sidetrack a little and take a creative way to look at an equation. An equation is not just a piece of mathematical formula. An equation is a symbolic representation. It is also a description, a language, a picture, or even a video. In view of the equation, we developed del dot S equals to a function of space and time representation, where S is an energy vector and time is a forward variable. We see that our temporal universe was created from a dimensionless singular explosion to a time-space dimensional representation. In fact, our universe is still expanding currently as based on current Hubble Space Telescope observation. Next slide, time and physical space. One of the most intriguing questions in our life is the existence of time. Let me pose a question. If time does not exist, then how do we know there is a physical space? Thus, it follows that there is a profound connection between time and space. If there is no time, then there will be no space. A physical space, in fact, is a temporal space, as in contrast with a virtual space. Temporal space is a space that is described by time, while virtual space is an imaginary space without the constraint of time. In other words, every temporal space is supported by the law of science, while virtual space may not be. Next slide, trading time for space. A TV displayed image is a typical example of trading time for space. Example, any TV display image of dx dy, that is the distance of x by distance of y, takes a section of time, delta t, to display it. Since time is a forward-moving variable, it cannot be traded back at the expense of space dx dy. Therefore, it is time that determines the physical space, and it is not the physical space that can bring back the amount of time, delta t, that had been used. And it is the size or dimension of space that determines the amount of time, delta t, needed to create the space. Speed of light. Based on current laws of science, speed of light is the limit. Since every physical space is created by substance, each physical space can be described by the speed of light. The dimension of a physical space is determined by the speed of light, and the space is filled with mass and energy. Why light speed is limited? It is because that our universe, with a gigantic physical space, is filled with substances that cause the time delay of electromagnetic wave propagation. Limited. If there are physical substance that travels beyond the speed of light, which remains to be found, then their velocities will also be limited, since our universe is compacted with substances. In principle, substance can travel within a space without any time delay, if and only if the space is absolutely empty or timeless. However, absolutely empty space cannot exist in practice, since every physical space that is our universe has to be fully filled with substances, and it has no empty space in it. We know that a timeless space is not a temporal space, and it does not exist within our temporal space. Now let's look at dark energy and dark matters. It is known that our current universe is composed of 72% dark energy, 23% dark matters, and the rest physical substances are about 5%. Since dark matters are in mass forms, they contribute about 23% of the universal space, but they dominate the entire universal energy reservation, that is over 95%, based on Einstein's energy equation. Now let's briefly turn to the Big Bang Theory. As we accepted the Big Bang Theory for our universe creation, then the creation has to start with Einstein's energy equation as given by the equation below, where M represents a gigantic energy reservoir. Based on the Big Bang Theory, it is apparent that the creation of our universe was ignited by time and exploded debris, that is, matters and energy. They started to spread out in all directions like a balloon. The boundary, that is the radius of the sphere of the universe, expands at the speed of light as the created debris dispersed. It took about 16 billion light years of chaotic evolution to come up with the present form of constellation, and our universe is still expanding at the speed of light beyond our current observation. In view of recent Hubble Space Telescope observation, we see that galaxies at 15 billion light years and they are still moving away from us. This means that the creation process has not stopped yet. Due to intense converging gravitational forces from the newly created debris of mass, that is galaxies, dark matter, and others, at the same time, the universe might have started to decreate itself since the Big Bang started. Trading time for space. Let us now take one of the simplest connections between temporal space or physical space and time as given by the following equation. Distance equals to velocity times time. This equation may be one of the most unique representation in connecting between time and space. A three-dimensional Euclidean physical space can be described by dx, dy, dz equals to vx, vy, vz times t, where vx, vy, vz are the velocity vectors. Based on the current laws of science, speed of light is the ultimate limit. Then by replacing the velocity vectors with speed of light c, a Cartesian space coordinate can be described by dx, dy, dz equals to ct, ct, ct. Once again, we see that time can be traded for space, and space cannot be traded for time, since time is a forward variable. So we see that once time is expanded, we cannot get it back. It is, however, more appropriate to describe the space creation by means of using spherical coordinate representation. As based on the Big Bang theory, the boundary of our universe can be written as radius equals to velocity of light times time. We see that the edge or boundary of our universe is expanding at the speed of light, as illustrated in the next slide. This slide shows the creation of our universe, starting from a Big Bang explosion, that is transforming from a dimensionless point into a three-dimensional space with time representation. This slide shows a composite temporal universe in which we see that the boundary of the universe is limited by the speed of light times time. Conclusion. We have shown that time is an enigmatic variable in our universe. Without time, there will be no matter, no energy, no space, and no life. We have shown that energy and mass can be traded. We see that mass can be considered as an energy reservoir. We have also shown that a physical space cannot be embedded in an absolute empty space, and any physical space cannot have an absolute empty space within it. We see that every physical space has to be fully packed with substance, that is energy and mass. Since the physical space cannot be embedded in an absolute empty space, it is reasonable to see that our universe is a subspace within a more complex space. Of course, this remains to be found. We have also shown that it takes time to create a physical space, and the physical space cannot bring back the time that has been used for the creation. Since all the physical spaces are created by time and substance, this implies that the origin of our cosmos is created by time with a gigantic energy explosion. We see that every substance has to exist with time. Without the time ignition, the creation would not have taken place. Although time ignited the creation of our universe, it is the physical substance that show us the existence of time. We have concluded that our universe is a temporal space, and it's still expanding as based on our current observation. As we have accepted the Big Bang theory of creation, we have seen that our universe has not reached her half-life yet. We're not alone is almost an absolute certainty. Someday, we may find a right planet. Once upon a time, had harbored a civilization for a twinkle period of light time. Remark: essence of temporal universe, that is our home. Science is a law of approximation, and mathematics is an axiom of absolute certainty. Using exact math to evaluate inexact science cannot guarantee that the solution exists within our temporal universe. One important aspect of temporal universe is that one cannot get something from nothing. There's always a price to pay. Every piece of temporal subspace, that is, every bit of information, takes energy and time to create. Any science can be proven within our temporal universe is physically real. Otherwise, it is fictitious unless it is validated by experiments. The burdens of proof. Burden of a mathematical postulation. First, the burden is to prove that there exists a solution. Second, the burden is to find a solution. The burden of an emerging science, first burden is to prove its existence within our temporal universe. Second burden is to find out if we can afford to pay for it. In terms of energy and time, or energy, time, and intelligent information. For example, the creation of a simple facial tissue would take a huge amount of energy, time, and information that is equivalent to the amount of entropy to create a tissue. Let me emphasize, only humans on this planet Earth can make it happen. This slide shows Professor Stephen Hawking, who passed away recently. Stephen Hawking, a genius. Professor Hawking was a world-renowned astrophysicist, a respected cosmic scientist, and a genius. Although my discovery of temporal universe started with the same root of Big Bang explosion, it is not a subspace of Professor Hawking's universe. You may see from this presentation that my creation of temporal universe is somewhat different from Hawking's creation.